Hey, what's up guys? So today we're going to be going over the best build for Necromancer with the new set going into Season 21. But I do want to start off this video by saying that the LOD Nayers Necromancer build is still arguably the best build for Necromancer, but this video is going to be focusing on the best build for the new set. Now this build is not bad by any means, it's still considered one of the best builds for Necromancer. We're only within 3 to 5 greater rifts at the moment of recording this video compared to the LOD build, but this video is going to be the best build for the new set because, of course, the new season just came out, and with the new set, everyone is mostly interested in trying out the new content, so that's what we're going to be covering in this video. But again, both could be definitely argued that they are the best builds for Necromancer, but we're just covering this build over here with the new set. Now, there are different ways to play it. You can mix and match a few different skills, so I'll go ahead and put those down below in the pinned comment. In case I'm too fast on any of the things and you want to go more in-depth and maybe pause at any moment, feel free to go ahead and do so as well, but the builds will both be in the description box. But let's go ahead and kick it off with the basic idea and how the gameplay plays, as you guys are seeing it in the background here. So how it works is, basically, it's a Bone Spear build where you're going to be having the Simulacrums. You'll see that they're also casting Bone Spear when we cast Bone Spear, and they'll also be using Grim Scythe to apply a debuff to the enemies and also give us some damage reduction. But really what it comes down to is huge, massive amounts of damage with that 6-piece bonus, and then our Simulacrums will also be using the Bone Spear, and they'll be getting triple that amount of bonus. So most of the damage actually comes from them, but don't worry, it doesn't feel like a pet build at all because they're casting it really, really fast. And then on top of that, you get some damage reduction with the 4-piece bonus, and also your Simulacrums no longer take damage, and they're beginning all of those runes, and the cooldown is refreshed if you die. Just more so quality of life, but again, more damage reduction at the end of the day with that. So what makes this set also a little bit different here, we also have the Haunted Visions. It's got a new buff where Simulacrum drains 5% of your maximum life every second and lasts twice as long. But this has actually been buffed up, as you guys will see in the gameplay over here. But what it really comes down to is there's also another buff with Necromancer, which is the Razzus Volition over here. It makes it so Skeletal Mage gains another rune, but that doesn't matter because you're not doing Skeletal Mages. You're getting it for the damage reduction when your essence is not full. And so pretty much when you go ahead and start firing off your Bone Spear, that costs essence, therefore just extra damage reduction. That's essentially what has changed with the Necromancer. But let's go ahead and go over all the pieces of gear and what you're kind of looking forward to getting on your pieces of gear. So there are some rooms for different variations of this build, and I'll get into that when we show off the other build. So in case any of you guys look at this and be like, wait, hold on, leaderboard, there's someone else running this, they're very similar and you can mix and match some of these. But pretty much what you're looking for in terms of the gear is you're looking for 5 pieces of the set, the Masquerade of the Burning Carnival. Basically, you don't want to run the shoulders. The shoulders will be all guild, so you also have a bonus set here, getting extra damage and extra damage reduction from all guild set, because we will be running the Royal Ring of Grandeur. And in terms of other things that we're running, Dainty's Binding, we've also got Crispin's Sentence and the Convention of Elements. If you happen to roll bad on any one of these can be swapped out with equipping the Royal Ring of Grandeur, but pretty much those are the things that can be swapped. As far as inside of the cube, the Petrified Spike for more damage on your Bone Spear. We got Razzus Volition, I mentioned this already, for the damage reduction, and then Royal Ring of Grandeur, or again, either one of these could be put in the cube, it doesn't really matter. Whatever one happens to roll bad, feel free to go ahead and throw in the cube. But as far as that goes, this is pretty much your go-to things inside of the Kanai's cube. In terms of the full build over here, with the helm, we're really looking for that crit hit damage and then bonus to Bone Spear damage, and then our main stat, which is intelligence. And then anywhere where we can get some extra area damage, that would be on, let's say, our shoulders or our offhand, we're going to try to get area damage. Eventually, once you get to a high enough Paragon level, you're going to be able to roll off intelligence. If you need to go ahead and get more life over that, you can do so. But this build is relatively tanky. But yeah, area damage is quite great. So pretty much look for area damage on your shoulders. The rest of the stats don't really matter too much. You don't really need cooldown reduction like you would on some builds. As far as our amulet, we're really looking for that area damage and our crit hit, chance crit hit damage, and then main stat. And you can also, if you want to get X elemental, whatever you decide to roll. In our case, it's going to be poison, but there are other builds. Physical is like the only real other competitive one, but if you want a speed build, the cold build would be the better choice if you're just doing T16 like speeds. For our gloves over here, this is where it differs. You can get attack speed or you can get area damage as well. Those are both, again, viable options at the end of the day if you happen to get that instead of attack speed. But crit damage is basically what you're looking for. As far as our chest piece, nothing too specific. You can get life or reduction from elite damage. And then for our bracers over here, the only thing we're really looking for, same thing on everything, is crit hit chance. And then you also want to have that element, which in our case is going to be poison. And then with Deity's Binding, nothing too special with here. We're just using it for that damage reduction. With Crispin's Sentence, if you don't happen to get a good one, go ahead and put that inside of the cube. One thing I do want to mention is attack speed is very, very powerful for this build, because remember, your simulacrums will also be casting that bone spear. So when you're increasing your attack speed, you're actually getting basically double, if that makes sense, because you get two other guys casting the bone spear as well, which is going to significantly increase your damage. So if you can get attack speed again on any of the pieces of gear instead of area damage or whatever the case may be, it's definitely also very viable. There's a lot of room for this build here. And then for the pants, nothing spectacular, just int vitality armor. And then for our othering, the convention of elements, again, attack speed is kind of a priority stat that you're looking for on a lot of the pieces of gear. With Scythe of the Cycle over here as our main source of damage here, we're also making it so our secondary skills deal 4,000% additional, or 400% additional damage while our bone armor is activated, but it will reduce the remaining duration of bone armor by 4 seconds. So pretty much it's just casting bone armor, teleporting around, and it feels really good. And then for our boots, just get that bonus to our bone spear damage. Instead of the all resist, you can also get armor, but it's pretty much the same. Nothing too special with that. For offhand, it could be literally anything. You'll see lots of builds running lots of different things. It doesn't matter too much as far as the offhand. You're just really looking to get, of course, it being an ancient item, and try to get where you can that area damage and bone spear damage and crit hit chance. It's kind of asking for a lot, but if you can also get plus to maximum essence, that can also be good. But again, it's really difficult to try to get all of those stats because rolling that plus to bone spear damage is an absolute nightmare. So if you can, what I recommend you guys to do is if you have something that has that plus bonus damage to bone spear and it has either crit hit chance or that area damage, roll off whatever else you can to get one of whatever you need. Basically, you'll have a relatively high chance to get that crit hit chance, but getting that area damage and bone spear and crit chance is just a nightmare. Try to get that bone spear damage, because if you do, keep that on it and you reroll something else, you can't roll plus damage to like another ability. So it makes your life a lot easier. Now, in terms of the other things that you can run, you'll notice the gems definitely do differ. You'll see some people will be running cooldown reduction. Some people will be running a topaz here to get extra resource cost, because you do definitely go through resource very, very fast with this build. So there are a few different play styles here. So either a topaz, if you're really running out of resource, or if you're not able to upkeep your bone armor because of course you need that extra cooldown so you can refresh it, because it will run out if you keep on spamming it super fast. So whatever one that you need to go for, go for it. If you need more damage, you can run the topazes. There are lots of builds on the leaderboard still using topazes, but if you are having trouble with survivability, then throw in either the green gems, the emeralds, or the rubies for strength, which at the end of the day is just armor, is what these will give you. In terms of the gems, there's a few different plays that you can mess around with. You have options for Bane of the Trapped, the Zay's Stone of Vengeance, and then Bane of the Stricken. Alternatively, what has been seen on leaderboards is the Gogok of Swiftness. This is due to the increased attack speed. You also have some survivability, and with this, you will have extra cooldown, so you cannot run the diamond. That's why a lot of people are choosing this. It gives you that cooldown reduction, so you have that extra resource cost reduction. But again, remember, attack speed is very powerful in this build, because again, your simulacrums will also firing out. Now, in terms of the skills and passives, there's a few different options here as well. So first off, as far as Blood Rush goes, some people are running Metabolism. There's a lot of different runes that you can run here. Pick whichever one that you like to mess around with. I like Metabolism just because I like to be able to blink twice. But there are, again, multiple choices with this. Bone Armor, Harvest of Anguish over here, so you can have additional movement speed. And then we have Simulacrum with Reservoir, but it doesn't matter, it's getting all the runes anyways. And then here's where some people will differ. There is Frailty with the Aura of Frailty, so you'll have an aura that will go ahead and curse and kill all the enemies with less than 15% health, which will go ahead and proc, of course, your dainties. Or you can run Decrepify, so you can go ahead and slow them down. It's just so you can apply curses at long range. I personally, if you were to ask me which one do I prefer, I like the aura because one, I don't have to cast it. Two, it doesn't cost essence, so I'm focusing more on Bone Spear. That's my personal choice, but both of them are on the leaderboard, so I'll go ahead and mention it. And then we're running Grim Scythe, so we can gain resource if we need to get resource. And remember, our Simulacrums will be also gaining it. Also want to mention one thing that's pretty important is originally there were people, and in my older video, I showed off that we were running the Pet Gem. These, just like, what is it, the Mask of Jerem, it doesn't count as a bonus damage to pet, so don't try to run the Pet Gem over here to get bonus damage with your Bone Spears. It doesn't work like that, but I just wanted to update you guys, just in case any of you guys did see that on the leaderboard and you guys were running it, or if you watched my older video, yeah. Anyways, Bone Spear with Blighted Marrow. This is for poison, and Bone Spear damage gets increased for enemy that it does go through, so that's how you're getting some insane amount of damage with it. Now, as far as other options, again, you can run the physical one, but most people will just say the poison one's better, and I'll agree. Most of the better builds are using poison, but if you want to go for speed, the cold rune can be viable, and if you want to clear out things super fast too, the physical rune is also viable. But they just technically do a little bit less damage. Technically, the ice one fires really fast. But as far as the passes, we have standalone Ceration, the Spreading Malediction, and Bone Prism. Other options over here can be the Dark Reapening. So that means when you get a kill, you'll get extra essence. Again, if you're having troubles with maintaining your essence cost, this could be a great option. Funnel Service is also great. That'll make it so if you rip, you have a second chance over here. But those are all the variations and the differences with the builds. And if you guys want to, let's say, put a diamond in your helm and you want to run the extra damage, feel free to go ahead and do so as well. You can mix and match. These aren't like set in stone. There are different ways to go ahead and play, and you can definitely mix and match some of these. But anyways, hopefully this video guide helped you guys out. And thanks for watching, guys. And if you enjoyed the video, drop a like on it. And if you're new here, subscribe and turn that bell so you don't miss out on more Diablo videos in the future. And if you guys want to check out the best build for Demon Hunter, I know that's also very popular. You can go ahead and check the description box, and it'll be pinned down there below, along with some other Diablo videos. But take care, guys, and I'll catch you in the next video. Good luck, and I hope you get a Primal Ancient. And I'm out. Peace.